Hello and welcome back to another video. My name is Mike Davies, and in today's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to batch edit images using BIMP, which is a free plugin for GIMP. I'll be using GIMP version 2.10.22, which is the latest version of GIMP at the time of this tutorial. Before I get into that, don't forget to check out my website at daviesmediadesign.com. As always, I have tons of GIMP, Inkscape, and Darktable tutorials on here. You can get more by becoming a DMD Premium member, and I have tons of free software help articles, so definitely check that out. You can enroll in my GIMP 2.10 Masterclass from Beginner to Pro Photo Editing on Udemy, and as I mentioned, you can get more with a premium membership to Davies Media Design, and I'll include a link to this as well as all the relevant links from this tutorial in the description of the video. So this is actually a new version of a tutorial I did a couple of years ago. The reason I feel the need to redo it is that the method for actually downloading this plugin has changed. So this was the original website where you used to be able to download BIMP. I mean, you could still download it from here, but it's gonna be out of date from this source and it might trigger your antivirus software. So I don't recommend downloading directly from the website anymore. And the developer on this project, Alessandro Francesconi, has moved everything over to this GitHub page. I will link this page in the description of the video so you guys can easily find it. But you'll see here the most recent update to this was 2 months ago, and this is going to be via the README file. So you are going to want to click into the README file. So it says README.md. That's going to bring you to a list of pertinent instructions for downloading and installing this into your GIMP. So below this photo here, you're going to see some instructions installing on Windows, compiling and installing on Linux for those of you using Linux computers, and then for Mac OS X users for those of you using Mac. So I'm going to scroll up. For this tutorial, I'll be installing this for Windows. So you'll see here it works for 32 or 64-bit machines. What you're going to do is click on this link and download the executable file. So I'll click here on the GitHub link, and here you'll see it says GIMP plugin BIMP win32.exe. So you're going to click on that, download this to your downloads folder, and below here you'll see your executable file. Just click on that to open it up. So you'll probably get a security message from your Windows computer if you're using Windows, but then you're just going to walk through here and it's going to automatically install this. So I'll hit next, and you'll see here on the last page of the installation window, it's going to tell you exactly where this is located inside of GIMP. So it's going to be under File, Batch Image Manipulation. So let me close this out. All right, once we have downloaded the BIMP plugin, now we can actually start batch image editing. So here I am inside of GIMP. I happen to have an image opened here, but you don't need to open an image to get started on this. So let me just do a quick demonstration of a batch edit. So I'll go to File, Batch Image Manipulation. So here is our main dialog window for this plugin. So you'll see you have the manipulation set. This is where you add various edits you want to perform on your photos. We'll get to that in a second. Below that, you have your input files and options. So this is basically where you add the images you want to edit. Then you have your output folder. This is where you decide where your edits are going to be outputted to. So let me first start by adding my images. So I'll click Add Images and then Add Folders. So this allows me to add multiple images. So here I have my folder that contains all the images I want to edit for this first example. So I don't need to double click inside the folder, just single click on it and then click add. So that will add all of my photos in here. These are all free stock photos from Unsplash, as you could see in the name there. So let me just come over here to my file explorer. These are going to be the original images. These are all stock photos from Unsplash. So you can see what these look like by default. I'm going to exit out of here and minimize this. Coming back to the BIMP plugin. Now we're going to add some edits to this. I'll just start with some basic edits. So when I click add, it's going to give me a drop down of some edits that are included in here. So pretty much all these are going to be included by default, but let's just scale these or resize these. So click the resize option. So let's say I want to cut the width and height in half. So I could type 50. And the unit right now is percent. You can also go with pixels, or if you don't want to touch the width, you can disable it. But let's go with 50-50. You can lock the aspect ratio here, so just set this to preserve if you want to make sure your images don't get stretched. And the interpolation is going to be the quality of the scale. If you have a really slow computer, you could stick with Cubic. Otherwise, you can go with NoHalo if you want to keep the final quality up a little bit. And I'll click OK to apply these. So that's going to add the resize to my manipulation set. Let's also add a crop to this. So let's come over here to the second option of crop. So right now, by default, this is set to an aspect ratio of 1:1. You'll see there are several other presets in here, or you could set your own manual crop using these values based on pixels. I'm gonna go with 1:1, which will give us square images. And then this is going to allow us to start the crop from the center. If you wanna crop your images from a different location, you can choose any of those options, and I'll click OK. Lastly, let's go with some sharpening here using Sharp or Blur. So you'll notice this does not use the settings you would usually find in something like the Unsharp Mask filter found inside a GIMP. So this is pretty much using its own little settings. You go to the left, it's more sharpening. Go to the right, it's more blurring. So let's add some sharpening and click OK. So now that we've got all of our manipulations or all of our edits set here, now let's come over and choose where we want to output these. So I'm going to go with the original photos to batch edit folder. So I'll double click to enter that. And then I actually have a final batch edits folder set up here. You can always click to create a new folder inside a folder if you want to. So I'll double click on that. So this is where our images will be saved. So I'll click OK. You can see that's going to update over here. And now let's click apply. And you can see the progress bar down here as it works on these images. Once it's complete, it'll say end all files have processed with zero errors, providing that nothing went wrong. So let's come back here to our File Explorer. So now we have images inside of this folder, and you'll see they are now cropped into a square, so they are a 1:1 aspect ratio. And when I double click on these, they also have some sharpening applied, which is kind of hard to tell because these were already edited. But there is just one example, and I do want to point out the size of this, 188 kilobytes. Let's come back over here. The size of this one was 0.98 megabytes. So almost a full megabyte, and there you could see the original dimensions there, and there's the dimensions of the new image. So remember, we scaled it down, we cropped it, and we applied some sharpening. All right, so that's it for this video on batch editing photos inside of GIMP. But if you like this video, don't forget to click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and click the bell icon to be notified each time I have a brand new tutorial. You can check out any of the links to my resources in the description of the video. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.